Hello, welcome to my channel. Today my topic is simulating accelerations in computer animation. It's in your fourth block. So let's start. First we go through these topics. We should know the meaning of acceleration, the rate of change of velocity per unit time. So you already read in physics in class 11th and 12th, acceleration, the rate of change of velocity per unit time. And what is the velocity? Velocity is a fundamental concept in kinematics, the branch of classical mechanics that describes the motion of bodies. Velocity is a physical and vector quantity in both magnitude and direction are needed to define it. Next we go to simulating accelerations. And third definition is also important for this topic, computer simulation. What is simulation? When we are doing animation, this is very important to know what is computer simulation. The use of computer to represent the dynamic response of one system by the behavior of another system modeled after it. If we want to see the very easy meaning, a simulation uses a mathematical description or model of a real system in the form of computer program. Means we are making a model. So first we discuss simulating accelerations, and you already know the meaning. There are different ways of simulating motion. First is zero acceleration, negative acceleration. In non-zero acceleration, negative accelerations or decelerations and combination of deceleration. We will discuss these topics in this video. Let's start from simulating accelerations. And simulating acceleration here is zero acceleration. Zero acceleration is constant, means constant speed. When we go sometimes assume that we are driving a car at the same speed. So it's a constant speed, in the same speed 80 km per hour, so it's a zero acceleration. Or we see with the language of computer graphics here, the time spacing for in between frames, or is it equal interval? If we want an in between for keyframes at a time TA, TB, then the time interval between keyframes is divided into n plus 1 subintervals, leading in between spacing of change in time given by the expression. Let's see through this example. Here is constant speed and here is a fixed interval. See, in between frames, time spacing is fixed, constant speed. Now we go to another non-zero accelerations. Or if we say about the zero acceleration, a linear curve leads to zero animation. Non-zero acceleration. This technique of simulating the motion is quite useful, means more than zero, and it's quite useful introducing the realistic displays of speed changes, especially at the starting and completion of motion sequence. To model the startup and slowdown portion of any animation path, we use splines or trigonometric functions. Trigonometric functions are more commonly used in animation packages, whereas parabolic cubic function are used in accelerating modeling. So let's discuss positive acceleration. In order to incorporate increasing speed in an animation, the time spacing between the frames should increase so that great change in the position occur as the object moves faster. In general, trigonometric function used to have increased interval size function 1 minus cos omega and 0 less than omega and pi / 2. pi divided by 2. Or for an in between, the time for the j in between would be calculated as, and you can see the formula in your book also, it's change in time j and ta plus triangle t 1 minus, sorry, triangle change in time 1 minus cos j n oblique 2 n plus 1. Here j is in between would be calculated to be between and represent a positive acceleration here. So we can see the figure in negative in zero acceleration. If we see positive acceleration in this figures, there is a in zero acceleration there is a fixed time intervals, but in positive acceleration these are increasing. Speed is increasing, or in negative acceleration speed is decreasing. So here is a diagram. What I am showing this diagram only for explaining and for making diagram for exam. You refer to book, you can refer to your book. So in positive acceleration speed is increasing, or in negative acceleration speed is decreasing. So we discussed negative and negative accelerations. Now we come to combination of accelerations. In combination of acceleration, speed is increasing and decreasing both. Let's see with this example. Here is a constant speed, but in combination accelerations, first speed is increasing. These distances are increasing. And we remove this. And here, to increase ho jayega, or then these are decreasing. So we can change this diagram. So, in order to incorporate increasing speed and animation, the time specific between the frames should increase so that greater change in the position occur as the object moves farther is a positive acceleration. And in negative acceleration, in order to incorporate decreasing speed in an animation, the time specific between the frames should decrease so that there exists lesser change in the position as the object moves. In general, trigonometric function used to have increased interval size, the position is sin omega and 0 less than omega and pi divided by 2. For an in between, the time in the time for the jth between would be calculated as tj ta plus change in time sin j pi by 2 n plus 1. So you can see diagram in the book also. So I think you cleared this, and we discuss combination of positive negative acceleration. In reality, it is not that body once accelerated or decelerated will remain so, but the motion may contain both speed ups and slowdowns. We can model a combination of accelerating decelerating motion by first increasing the in between spacing, then decreasing the same. The trigonometric function used to accomplish these time changes is y minus 1 minus cos omega divided by 2 and 0 less than omega pi by divided by 2. The time for jth in between is calculated as tj ta plus change in time 1 minus cos j pi divided by n plus 1 divided by 2. Here is a change in time difference between two frames tb and ta. So, as TB is TA and TB. So, in combination of negative and positive, so there is a here is increasing or here is decreasing. So, it's a combination of. You can see a diagram in your book also, and you better understand from that. The time interval for moving object first increases and then time decreases, leading to the simulation of motion, that first acceleration and then deceleration. Thanks for watching. and there are more videos coming in computer graphics and other topics also, Python, machine learning. So please subscribe my channel, because it motivates me to making more videos. If it is useful, share to your friends. Thanks for watching.